Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another fantastic episode of Let's Play Lego Star Wars. After leaving off on the last episode, we followed the bounty hunter down, and now we need to go to, Dexter Man here. That's Dex. Let's see what the problem is. And, of course we can't talk to him. Of course it defaults us using the Force, but we need to feed a bunch of people the food that they ordered here. This is just sort of like a little Lego side mission. All of the Lego games have, like, side missions like that exist. I apologize for any background noise as well, too. I just filled up my, my water jug thing, water cooler here, and, it decided to just start humming away, so hopefully that is resolved in this episode and does not carry over next episode, because I am doing episode 9 and 10 back-to-back here, but we'll see. We have to give people what they ordered, so first we have to go and ask people what they ordered. It shows us a little image, and then we have to drop that off on their table there. Although we should have started with some of, like, the easier ones, like, obviously, this is not what this person ordered. So let's put that back. That'll work. Right there will work. So they ordered Jawa juice. See if we can find... That's definitely Jawa juice right there, yeah. He sounded like a clone. That's interesting. This person wanted this thing here. Sandwich. Give them their sandwich. Where's my shot at club sandwich? Yeah, I'm trying to put it on the table, buddy.
Looks delicious.
What'd you order? Not the Force. Cake. Cake should be easy to identify right there. Let's put that right there. Two people over here by the window. I get that they're being quirky and, like, what they're saying is, like, kind of funny and, like, relevant to, like, Star Wars, but... Photon Fizzle. That has to be the green drink that I dropped on the ground. Can you go get my photon fizzle? Okay, yeah, I know. I know, ma'am. I'm trying to put it on your table.
Did everyone get their order? Now, what do you want to talk about?
Yeah, I want to talk about this poison dart.
What you got here is a Kamino saber dart.
Kamino, oh. I'm not familiar with it. Is it in the Republic?
No, it's beyond the Outer Rim.
It's beyond the Outer Rim, Kamino.
Keep to themselves. They're cloners.
Cloners. No, Arthur, I don't recall Kamino on any of the usual charts.
Yeah, we don't have Kamino there.
Let's head to the archives.
And that person's been hit with a Kamino saber dart somehow. But yeah.
Let's run the coordinates Dex gave us through the Jedi Archives.
Let's go check the Dex and see if we can find it. I just want to drive this thing. We haven't driven any of these yet. I want to have some fun for a couple minutes. Can I take this right off? We'll find out. Yes, I can. Very nice. Otherwise, I was just going to jump down there anyway, so... Let's go to where we need to go. We have arrived. Let's take it inside. Making my way uptown, throwing my lightsaber. Doing cool moves. Okay, yeah, I cut out some of the mumbo jumbo there. So here we go. We're gonna go and look at, like, the holocron data and things like that. Into the Jedi Library to see if we can learn more about Kamino. Now I need R4. Move out of the way, Obi-Wan. This is just like a simple lock and hold kind of thing. I think you just need to make a clear path to, like, the center. Yeah, see, sometimes it, like, lets me do it like that, sometimes not so much. It's really confusing, like, how that works. I'm sure someone will point out in the comments that it's, like, actually really easy and I'm just being an ignoramus, but... Kamino should be here, but it's just empty.
Lost a planet, Master Obi-Wan has. How embarrassing.
There's nothing there.
Yeah, thanks, Yoda. It's been erased.
Center of gravity's pole and find your planet.
Find the planet. Thanks, Yoda.
But Master Yoda, who could empty information from the archives? That's impossible, isn't it?
Only a Jedi could have erased those files. But who?
And who would have erased it?
Harder to answer. Meditate on this, I will.
Thanks, Yoda. You meditate, buddy. You'll figure it out. I'm sure Yoda will figure it out in time. He'll know exactly. Hopefully he can figure it out. I'm sure he'll figure it out. Master Yoda is one of a kind. Let us go. We'll go back to where my ship is.
No apps, no drivers, no.
Then I guess we'll be taking our ship to Kamino. Here's our ship stationed. The Lego ships look pretty cool. I have to give them that. Like, even in comparison to, like, the actual ships in the game, or, like, in the movies, they look pretty spot on. They look fun. And I guess that makes sense. Like, when Lego started coming out with toys, like, the ships were, like, the big thing growing up, I remember. Like, they actually looked like the ships from the movies. So, like, to see that carried on into here kind of makes sense. You know, it makes sense that, like, that would be what they are the best at putting out there.
Yes.
Here we go, there's Kamino. We should be able to land here. Yep, straightforward. The Secrets of Kamino. Kamino is, like, one of those worlds that, like, you either love it or you hate it. Like, I mean, I don't even know how I feel about it, honestly. It's like, it's not as relevant as it should be in the movie that it's introduced. I feel like that's, like, my big, like, there should have been much more of an emphasis on Kamino. Like, there's too many planets in the Attack of the Clones that, like, not a single one really sticks with me all that much. You know what I mean? Hopefully that makes sense. And we are, like, the episodes here for Attack of the Clones, at least this second one here, is a little bit longer than the usual. So that might be a trend to stay here for, like, I don't know, Attack of the Clones, I guess. Maybe we could start approaching, like, the 15-minute mark there. I don't know if I was just, like, caught in the middle of things and that's why this episode's a little bit longer, but I know, like, eventually I sort of got, like, down-packed how long I want these videos to be. Like I said, I apologize for the background noise in this video. I know there's likely going to be some humming. But, yeah, it just so happened to be right around the time I filled up my water jug. So, Master Sifo Dyas ordered this army to be built.
I'm sorry, Master Sifo Dyas. But he was killed almost 10 years ago.
Yeah, he's dead.
I'm so sorry to hear that.
But they built us a clone army.
I'd hoped you would be pleased. Clones can think creatively. you will find that they are immensely superior to droids.
I'm sure.
No offense, R4. I don't know, R4 is pretty smart. He's jumping over plants and stuff over there. Look at him. Yeah, so they use some growth acceleration so that way they get older quicker.
Taking any order without question, we modify their genetic structure to make them
less independent than their original host.
And who was the original host?
Yeah, who was the original host? Jango Fett, the bounty hunter.
I would very much like to meet this Jango Fett.
And I would be very happy to arrange it for you. Apart from his pay, which is
good. Apart from his pay, which is good, all he wanted was an unaltered clone of himself.
Curious, isn't it?
Unaltered?
Pure genetic replication. No tampering with the structure to make it more docile, and no growth acceleration.
Yeah, he just wanted a little kid. Little kid copy of himself as a clone. For those that aren't aware, Jango Fett, the cloned version of him, that's the kid, is Boba Fett from the later series, so there's a cool tie-in there. Jango Fett and Boba Fett are essentially the same person. I mean, there's a lot of differences and things like that, but I mean, of course.
Would you like to meet him?
Yeah, it's me, Jango Fett.
This is Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi. He's come to check on our progress.
Your clones are very impressive. You must be very proud.
Then we see, like, the bounty hunter armor there.
I was recruited by a man called Tyrannus.
I was recruited by a man named Tyrannus. Your army cool? I mean, they don't seem effective based off of like the 2 minutes I've seen of them.
Thank you for your time, Jango.
Always a pleasure to meet a Jedi.
I have a strong feeling that this bounty hunter is the assassin we're looking for.
And there he goes, dressed up as the bounty hunter that we're looking for. So yeah, it showed his name there. I wasn't spoiling too much. That's Boba Fett.
He'll be wanting to leave quick.
Who is the son of Jango Fett. Boba Fett will be a much, not a much bigger deal, but it's a cool tie-in to the original trilogy. Whereas Jango Fett is more prevalent here. Here we go, Jango Fett. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we are approaching the point in time where we only have about 2 minutes left in this episode. If you like this episode, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe. All that good stuff is greatly motivational for myself, continuing to make videos just like this now and in the near future. We'll be playing this series here on Mondays and Wednesdays, and then we'll be playing Pokemon Alpha Sapphire on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So if this series really isn't your cup of tea, feel free to check that out as well. Looks like we are making some very, very good progress on this series here so far, and hopefully that continues to be the path moving forward. I know I have a couple episodes pre-done that I'm getting ready to post here. I'm doing 9 and 10 back-to-back, and it sounds like the water cooler has stopped, so you have something to look forward to in episode 10. No background humming noise there. Once again, I apologize for that. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you like this episode, and we hope to see you on the next one. Until then, peace out, Girl Scout.
We mustn't let them get too far ahead. Let's go. Force reflexes have their advantages, Arthur. Now there's no time to waste. Let's follow him.